The themes of time passing are a regular concept in Magic the Gathering, starting way back from the beginning of Magic's history. The first example of this are the basics from 5th edition, drawn by David O'Connor, John Avon, Pat Morrissey, and Andrew Robinson in 1997, that depict the same individual areas, just at different seasons of time. Winter, spring, summer, and fall. Merch. Like, comment, subscribe. Hello, welcome back to Basics, a show where I take EDH commanders and try to find the perfect basic lands to fit them. I love seeing someone sit down with some beautiful basic lands, but something I love even more is seeing how well those lands match their commanders. One quick note before we begin. I like to give the artists credit for their artworks, but I may not pronounce their names perfectly. I'll try my best, but please forgive me and correct me if that ever happens. First up, we've got Rionya Fire Dancer from Commander 2021. One of the things that was very easy to notice was the motion in the artwork. The flaming arcs that she's tracing with her knives along with the dim purples and blues in the background to contrast make her design choices very specific. And I found more examples of this than I thought that I would. For instance, this mountain from Commander 2016, illustrated by Mark Poole, has bright red and blue hues, forming a curling image of a mountain that mimics the movement of Rionya as she dances. In addition, we could go with this mountain from M21, designed by Jonas Durow, with these strangely shaped finger-like structures that are making slow curls around the artwork, as well as the bright red flame at the bottom of the card frame to match the trail she makes with her knives. Or finally, you could go with this full art mountain from Zendikar Rising, illustrated by Sam Burley, that matches her color palette almost exactly, while placing primary emphasis on the bright ribbons of flame that she trails behind her. Next up, we've got Grevin Predator Captain, which is probably the most strangely colored Rakdos commander I've seen before, so I ended up having to do a lot of work for him. It is a unique occurrence to see such a brightly colored composition in red and black themed commanders, which made this one particularly nuanced and difficult to pin down. The teals and greens of the orb behind Grevin, along with the brightly colored gold filigree in the symbol behind him, served to mute the intensity of the reds and blacks of his actual person and his card frame. With all that in mind, I have three different land pairings that I think go quite nicely together for him. The first is this mountain from Mercadian Masks, illustrated by Terry Springer, and that is paired with this swamp from Portal, illustrated by Romas. These two lands really emphasize the golds in the filigree and his card frame itself while also having the old border on them, which could be important from a lore perspective because Grevin is part of the story of the Weatherlight, one of the first major story arcs in MTG history, and the old border might serve to match that. The second option is this swamp from the Secret Lair drop illustrated by Bob Ross, and we pair that with this mountain from Time Spiral designed by D. Alexander Gregory. In the sky of each of these lands, you'll see a gradient of greens and golds that help reinforce the greens and golds in the background of Grevin's artwork. And it helps that the compositions for all three images have a dark figure in the foreground, being silhouetted by the brightness and contrast of the images in the back. The third option is lore-based, because Grevin is technically a Phyrexian. So I went to the Plane of Mirrodin for this last pairing. This swamp from Mirrodin, illustrated by John Avon, and this mountain from Scars of Mirrodin, illustrated by Tomasz Jędruszek. Both of these resonate from a lore perspective, representing his augmenting of his body with Phyrexian technology, along with accenting the bright tone and reflecting the greens and golds that are present in his artwork. Third on the list, we've got Valduk, Keeper of the Flame, who has many different potential artworks to follow. His unique attributes that separate him from other mono-red commanders is how much yellow is present in the artwork. From the deepening of the yellow hues nearing the bottom of the artwork, to the gold colors on the wall behind him, yellow tassels, and his gold belt buckle and hammer. Another thing to note is how unfocused the brushstrokes are in this artwork. The lines almost fade into one another like a haze, as though you're staring through the smoke and stifled air in Valduk's forge. So I leaned into that by looking at this mountain from Global Series Jiang Yanggu and Mu Yanling, illustrated by Gaga Zhang. I feel like it accentuates the smoky haze, as well as the yellow and warm tones in Valduk's artwork. Another choice was to focus on his gameplay mechanics that emphasize that he is working as a weaponsmith, and uses those weapons to gain power over fire. So take a look at this mountain from Ravnica, illustrated by Stepan Martinier, that places particular interest in the lava pouring into an industrial center of a city. I feel like it matches perfectly the forge aesthetic that Valduk is going for. Fourthly, we've got Imodi, Celebrant of Bounty. The aesthetic aspects I fell in love with were particularly the sky blue energy coming from her hands, being so light and airy while still being the strongest parts of the image. It really helps the scene to feel clean and bright, while also contrasting the gold colors in the background tile and her skin tone. So I started there, with this island from Commander 2019, and this forest from Ikoria, both illustrated by Elena Danner. I feel like this matches the bright and cheerful energy that she gives off, while also focusing on that sky blue amidst the heavy green tones. The second pairing was to look at the yellow tones in her artwork and find a pairing that matches that. So the first was a forest from Commander Anthology designed by Rob Alexander, which is actually a reprint from Lorwyn with higher contrast that brings out the yellows quite a bit more. From there we pair it with this island from Rivals of Ixalan designed by Dimitar Marinsky. I feel like the pleasant greens and golds dominating the artworks of all three could be accented by the bright sky blue in the background of the forest and in the card frame of the island. And finally, we have Kalamax, the Storm Sire, who is particularly difficult. Being a three-color commander offers many choices of land pairings, but for Kalamax specifically, his artwork is uniquely gray, and not reflecting any of the color at all from his color identity besides the light blue radiating from his scales. However, his form is the darkest image on the composition, so I started there, looking for lands that have muted colors with heavy silhouetted elements, and I think I found it in this mountain from Dragons of Darkir, illustrated by Titus Lunter, this island from Time Spiral, illustrated by Craig Mullins, and this forest, designed by Young Park from Zendikar. I feel like each one of these emphasizes the dark, imposing figure of Kalamax, by having low contrast for the color styling, but high contrast for the overall tone of the composition. But there you have it, 5 more commanders sorted for which basic lands I think match them best. But I want to see what you think. Tell me which commanders you'd like me to try and pick out basic lands for. Comment below and let me know.